join us to honor the sixth cohort of Pomegranate Prize recipients. It's really hard to believe it's the sixth group, but it is a family. I'm seeing some of the first group out there, and very happy to be presenting this award this morning. We're so glad that you're here. And we know that meeting this fifth wonderful group of what we call POMs will inspire and challenge and engage you. To begin, you're going to now hear more about this outstanding group of educators. You have in your booklet a brief professional bio of each of our recipients, but I also get the opportunity to shine a light on how very special each one of them is by letting some of their own words introduce them to you. So in its alphabetical order, no favoritism. May I ask them to stand for a minute so they know? Okay, so first is Rabbi Adam Greenwald. If you'll just stand up for a minute. We're going to bring them all back up together again, but I want you to know who I'm talking about. Actually, I want you to know who he's talking about. Rabbi Greenwald is the director of the Lewis and Judith Miller Introduction to Judaism program at the American Jewish University in Los Angeles, California. And he does an amazing job with that program, as you can read in there. In thinking about his own work, Adam has written, quote, "There is no such thing as a one-size-fits-all educational experience. Rather, there's the opportunity to recognize real and pressing needs of individuals tied to a broader context of their lives and to produce experiences that are relevant and meaningful to particular moments of sacred opportunity. I envision, that's he envisions, building a network of Jewish educators across the United States who actively share best practices and engage in meaningful trainings to empower them to provide the highest quality educational experiences to those who are interested in joining the Jewish community." That's his quote. Beautiful. Next, Rachel Harari, please stand up. Rachel is Department Chair of English Language Arts and an English Language Arts teacher at Madden David Yeshiva High School in Brooklyn, New York. And does that sound, sounds a little like English, right? She weaves this throughout all of her work, and this is what she says about her work as an English teacher. Rachel writes, "Walking the halls of High Tech High," and you can read about that, "demonstrated the success of a project-based model of education. Students created projects that intertwined multiple disciplines using mathematical formulas, scientific theorems, the arts, and writing all at once. The concept of English language arts being taught in one classroom with science in another does not apply in the real world. As a result of the current model, it's difficult for our students to understand that the reading and writing techniques they are learning in my classroom transcend to other classrooms as well. Students learn best when they have the freedom to be creative and to integrate their learning organically." Next, Alex Jakubowski. Executive Director of Kahal, Your Jewish Home Abroad, in Evanston, Illinois. Kahal facilitates transformative experiences for Jewish study abroad students. Who would think of that, right? They're all out there, those kids, and he's doing something unique for them. As he reflects on the goals of study abroad education, Alex shares the following. "I'm looking forward to building the infrastructure of the Jewish study abroad ecosystem in such a way as to facilitate the transfer of high-level, deeply engaging Jewish content to students wherever they go. Across the Jewish campus community, dozens of innovative organizations and professionals are creating and exploring new ways to engage students with their Jewish identity. One of my goals for our organization is to serve as a conduit for the global spread of innovative Jewish ideas and education. Next is Leah Kahn. Leah is the senior Jewish educator at Berkeley Hillel in Berkeley, California. In considering how best to support the community of Jewish college students with whom she works, Leah reflects, we urgently need educators who can inspire emerging adults to wrestle with Jewish tradition and who can support them in crafting Jewish lifestyles. I often hear engagement talked about as a means to increase program attendance, but personal, complex engagement can and must change people. The urgency of the moment is ultimately the solution to the urgency of the need. And Aharon Aharon Habib, last but not least, Greg Kellner. Greg is the director of the URJ 6 Points Sci-Tech. That's science. Academy in Lyndhurst, New Jersey. As he reflects on the blend of science and experiential education inherent in his work, Greg writes, by creating a holy place for children to investigate, explore, build, and create through science, their work becomes deeply rooted in Jewish values and thought. They grapple with some of the biggest questions of the universe, the existence of God, and the relationship between science and Judaism. It is through the idea of weaving Jewish values, lessons, and history into science education that we are able to provide the essential nutrients for a tree that will grow to be strong in the future. That's our poems. 5 wonderful new poems. And some of them I had to think about. I hope I conveyed the meaning by reading them. It's clear that this distinguished group of creative, talented, and passionate Jewish educators will continue to add tremendous value to the field of Jewish education for many years to come. We look forward to supporting them enthusiastically as they develop new ideas, build relationships with one another and with you, and work together toward a promising future. We would now like to recognize each one of you and present you with a gift from the Covenant Foundation. Please join me as I call your name again, Rabbi Adam Greenwald. Thank you. and Greg Kelly. Thank you.